गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक एम्पीयर्स एथिकल लॉ ऑफ क्लास 12. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द ड्यूज टॉवर्ड्स लॉ एंड इन दैट टॉपिक वी हैव फाइंड आउट हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अराउंड द करेंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर एंड इन दैट मेथड वी हैव यूज द करेंट एलिमेंट. नाउ हियर वी यूज द दिस वन ऑफ द अनदर साइंटिस्ट Ampere, who has given another method, and this is a very easy method to find out the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. In the Biot-Savart's law, he has taken the base, that is the current element, very smaller distance through which whenever electricity passed, then due to the current element, what is the amount of magnetic field produced by it. Here we also going to discuss about the if this is a wire and this wire carrying current, then what is the amount of magnetic field produced by it at different point. So Ampere has given one of the method, and that method is what? Suppose that if I amount of current is flowing through any conductor, suppose that this is any conductor and I amount of current is flowing through it. If I amount of current is flowing through it, then amount of magnetic field produced by this conductor is also I. But as we know that permeability, the amount of magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is decreases when moving from this point to different point. So suppose that the characteristic of medium, the permeability of the air maybe at this medium is mu. So what is the magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is mu into I, and we know that the permeability of the free space is mu naught. So the amount of magnetic field produced by the current carrying conductor I is mu naught into I. This is the amount of magnetic field produced by it. Now come to this point, the amount of magnetic field produced by the current carrying conductor I is equal to mu naught I. Then mu naught I is equal to close integral of BdL. From where we get this close integral of BdL? Suppose that if this is the current carrying conductor, then in first chapter you have studied about the Gaussian surface. If you want to measure the amount of flux, then first of all we imagine a Gaussian surface. So in this very law, here we imagine a Ampere loop. Here we imagine the Ampere loop. Suppose that this is any current carrying conductor, then magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is also circular, because we have already studied in previous chapter with the help of right hand thumb rule we can able to find out the magnetic field around the current carrying conductor. So suppose that this is any current carrying conductor, then magnetic field produced by it is circular. If I want to measure the magnetic field at around this very current carrying conductor, suppose that the amount of magnetic field at this point is phi. Maybe we imagine that amount of magnetic field at this point is phi. Then what is the total magnetic field produced by this current carrier? So we multiply this phi into phi into phi into phi. It means this close integral of this complete. So suppose that the total close integral path of this very conductor maybe is equal to what? 2 pi r. Suppose that this is the radius of this wire is r. So the close integral is what? 2 pi r. So we have taken here 5 into 2 pi r. So suppose that the radius, the diameter, or sorry, the perimeter of this very circular path is 100. So at this point, the total magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is how much? 500. If we measure at this point, then at this point, the amount of magnetic field produced at this point is 1. And the perimeter of this circular Amperean loop is, if the perimeter of this capital R is 500 meter, suppose that. Then what is the total magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor? If we multiply, if amount of magnetic field at this point B is 5, amount of magnetic field produced at this point Q is 1. Then we multiply simply, then if we multiply the perimeter and the amount of magnetic field, that is what? Close integral of BDL. So 1 into 500, it is how much? 500. Here 5 into 100, it is equal to how much? It is 500. So basically, if we measure the Amperian loop at any distance or point, then the total magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is always equal. So here we come to this point. This Ampere circuit law states that the amount of magnetic field produced by a current carrying conductor is equal to mu naught I is equal to close integral of BDL. B is the amount of magnetic field and DL is the very small length. So here the B is also vector and length is also vector. So the dot product of BDL is the close integral of BDL cos theta. Finally, we got the formula here. Mu naught I is equal to close integral of BDL cos theta. But we write in the language Ampere's circuit law. So here we write down the line integral of magnetic field along loop is the mu naught time of the electric current passing through it. Here Ampere's circuit law states that line integral of magnetic field, it means this is the line integral of magnetic field along loop is the mu naught time of the electric current passing through it. Now we are going to study about the application of Ampere's circuit law. Now here is application, we use application of Ampere's circuit law. Now here we, how we use this Ampere's circuit law to find out the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. Here you can able to see, this is a long straight wire carrying current around I. Now what is the magnetic field due to this current carrying conductor at P? So what are the steps you have to use for finding the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor with the help of Ampere's circuit law? So here we take a point P. At this point P, we want to find out the magnetic field due to this current carrying conductor. Now here P due to straight long conductor carrying current I. This is a straight long conductor carrying amount of current I. Now P is a point at normal distance R from current carrying conductor. This P is a point at normal distance R from this current carrying conductor is. Now let us consider an Amperian loop. Just like we have seen that in the previous topic, first of all we have to imagine Amperian loop around a current carrying conductor. So here we imagine Amperian loop in the form of circle. Here we imagine, let us consider an Amperian loop in shape of coaxial circle of radius R passing through point P. Wherever we want to find out the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor, we have to consider an Amperian loop. Then here we consider an Amperian loop in the form of circle, and that circle should pass through the point P. Now, since B is also, and assume that this is a current carrying conductor, so the magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is also circular. So the here you see, this is the magnetic field. Then angle between this Amperian loop and the magnetic field is how much? 0. Since B is also circular, so the theta is equal to 0. Now, what is the amount of here? So here, we want to find out the magnetic field, close integral of BDL cos theta. Close integral of BDL cos theta. As we know that this B is constant, here B remains same, B doesn't going to be changed. So we take out the B and close integral of DL and cos theta is equal to 0, so value become 1. So here BDL, and if this is in the form of circle, so what is equal to here? It becomes P 2 pi R, and the radius of this is equal to R. Now, according to Ampere's circuit law, here it is equal to mu naught I, it is equal to B 2 pi R. Now, this B is equal to how much? B is equal to mu naught I upon 2πr. Now, this is the amount of magnetic field produced by a state law current carrying conductor. Now, the second application is how can you find out the magnetic field of a to find out the magnetic field in and outside the conductor. Suppose that this is any conductor and we want to find out the magnetic field at different point. At this point, we want to find out the magnetic field outside the conductor. This is the P on the surface and this is the P inside the conductor. Now, what is the magnetic field at different points of a current carrying conductor? So, we use here the previous four steps to find out the magnetic field at outside, on the surface and inside. So first of all, suppose that this is any current carrying conductor and this is amount of current flowing through this conductor. Suppose that the amount of current flowing through this conductor is I. So at this point P, we want to find out the magnetic field. So first of all, we have to imagine an Amperian loop. So here we imagine an Amperian loop. So by the previous method, at this point P, the magnetic field when P is outside, B outside, mu naught I upon 2 pi r, when this r is greater than this r is radius of this wire current carrying conductor and this r is the distance from the center at this point P. Now, second is, suppose that what is the magnetic field on the surface of a current carrying conductor? Here, this is the point P and the distance from this center to the point P is R. So here, when P is on surface, then the B magnetic field on the surface is equal to mu naught I upon 2 pi R because here the distance R is equal to the radius of the R. Now third is to find out the magnetic field inside the current carrying conductor. Now, magnetic field inside the current carrying conductor is we want to find out the magnetic field at this point P. Now, the third is when P is inside. Now, when P is inside, what is the magnetic field of this? Now, according to Amperian rule, we know that first of all we want to find out the magnetic field of this. So, it is B dl cos theta. As we know that the magnetic field around this current carrying conductor is also circular, so that theta is equal to 0 degree, so it is equal to 1. Finally, it is equal to close integral of B dl cos theta is equal to 1. So we take out this B and close integral of dl. So finally, it is equal to B 2 pi r because here this r is greater than this r. So it is equal to 2 pi r. According to Ampere's theta law, current flowing through inside this Amperian loop, current passing through unit area is equal to I upon pi r square. R is the radius of this conductor. So the amount of current passing through per unit area is equal to I upon pi r square. Now how much amount of current passing through this is equal to the current through given loop. Current through this given loop is equal to I naught is equal to pi r square. This is the area of the given loop into this density of the current. Then pi r square into I upon pi r square. So finally it is equal to I r square upon r square. Now according to Amperian loop, mu naught I is equal to close integral B dl. So here it is mu naught I is equal to how much? I is equal to I r square upon r square. It is equal to B 2 pi r. Finally, what is the amount of magnetic field? At this point, the amount of magnetic field at this point is equal to B is equal to, finally this will come at this point, so it is equal to mu naught I r square upon r square, this to come this side 2 pi r. it get cancelled or finally we get B is equal to mu naught I R upon 2 pi R square. This is the magnetic field inside the current carrying conductor. Now,
here it is graphical representation of magnetic field inside the conductor, on the surface of the conductor and outside the conductor. With the help of graph, you can see that inside the conductor, on the axis of the conductor, the magnetic field is zero and the magnetic field is maximum on the surface of the conductor, and when we are going away from the conductor, gradually its magnetic field slowly and slowly decreases. Because inside the conductor, the magnetic field is directly proportional to R, and outside the conductor, magnetic field is inversely proportional to R. So the magnetic field is maximum on the surface, minimum inside the conductor, on the axis of the conductor, it is zero. And when we are going away from the conductor, outside the conductor, slowly and slowly, its magnetic field become finally zero.